extract, transform, load. How does the ETL process work? In part one of our ETL video series, we explained what the definition of ETL was. Check out its link in the caption if you haven't already. There are three main steps in the ETL process: extract, transform, and load. Together, they work to prepare your raw data for analysis and reporting. Let's take a look at each of the steps in detail below. Data extraction. Extraction, or data extraction, is the first stage of the ETL process. Most companies and businesses acquire data from a variety of sources, such as CRM files, ERP files, emails, Excel sheets, Word documents, log files, and other machine data. Leading companies in BI solutions, such as Cubeware, host hundreds of standard and custom-built data connectors, allowing their ETL tool to extract datasets from HubSpot, Google Analytics, CRMs, social media platforms, SAP, and many more data sources. With the automated ETL tool, this extraction stage is made easier and faster. Data transformation. This is where datasets are prepared before being loaded into a data warehouse for analysis and reporting. Given the volume and variety of sources that raw datasets come from, the transformation stage is widely known as the most critical step in the ETL process, as it optimizes data integrity and ensures that the data is fully compliant and available for use when it reaches its new location. Various sub-processes take place in the data transformation stage. For example, cleansing consists of resolving data discrepancies and incomplete information. Standardization entails applying formatting rules to the datasets to ensure uniformity. Deduplication is the process of removing or discarding repetitive data. Verification eliminates any inoperable data and highlights any anomalies. Sorting groups data into defined categories. When there is data that does not require any transformation, it is known as direct move or pass through data. Data loading. This is where the newly transformed data is collectively loaded into a new location. There are two main methods for this. First, we have the full load option, where data is loaded in bulk. With this method, all of the datasets coming out of the transformation phase are loaded into the centralized location from scratch. This means that any existing data that was loaded before is erased or deleted. Second, we have the incremental load option, where data is loaded in predetermined intervals. Here, datasets coming out of the transformation phase are loaded into the centralized location incrementally, instead of all in one go. With the incremental load option, the existing data is cross-checked first, allowing just the new and updated datasets to be loaded. In this option, the existing data is not deleted, but rather added upon. Well, that's it for our explanation of the ETL process. To learn more about data analytics, visit us at www.cubeware.com. In addition to building BI solutions, Intuition Analytics, powered by Cubeware, regularly curates educational articles on the most relevant components of the data analytics industry.